Hello students, this channel provides you the physics lecture for class 11-12 NEET and JEE in English version as well as in Bengali version. To see the all unit wise video lecture, go to the channel playlist. Today I will discuss about error. You have to know what is the error and the process of error calculation. If I measure a diameter of a wire and you measure the diameter of the same wire, the magnitude will difference. That means error measurement system is a process of comparison. That means measurement process is a essentially process of comparison. And in spite of our best effort, the measured value is somewhat different from actual value. So the error is defined the difference between measured value and actual value. That means what is the error? Error is the error equals to the true value minus measured value. This is the difference between true value and measured value. Now you have to know the physical quantities related to error. One is absolute error. Absolute error is defined as the magnitude of true value minus measured value. That means magnitude of the difference between true value and measured value. If I measure a physical quantity n times, that means a1, a2, a3 and .. an, then the mean value can be written as AM. Mean value is denoted by AM as follows: A1 plus A2 plus A3 plus AN divided by N. Now you have to know what is true value. This mean value is taken as a true value, because in reality the true value does not exist. So here the mean value of a physical quantity is taken as a true value. Now what is the absolute error? Here by the definition of absolute error, you can written as the absolute error of calculation A1, written as A mean minus A1. Absolute error of calculation of A2 can be written as A mean minus A2. This value, the magnitude, only magnitude, in this way you can written as del of AN. The absolute error of calculation of AN can be written as A mean minus AN. This is called the absolute error. Error can be written as follows. Now you have to know what is the mean of absolute error. The mean of absolute error can be written as del of A bar. Can be written in this way. That means del of A1 magnitude plus del of A2 magnitude plus dot 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 del of An magnitude divided by N, divided by N. Now, what you have already learned that what is absolute error. In absolute error can be written as follows. The mean of the absolute error is can be written as follows. Now, any measurement quantity, the measured value can be written. That means measured value of a physical quantity can be written as del of a mean, that means mean value plus minus the mean of the absolute error. In this way you can written the measured value of a physical quantity. This implies that the value of these physical quantities lies between del A mean plus this and this. So the measurement value of a physical quantity can be written as in this way, and this implies that this measurement values lies between this and this. Now you have to know what is the fractional error or relative error. What is the fractional error or relative error? Fractional error is defined as the ratio of mean absolute error divided by mean value. That means mean absolute error divided by mean value. And percentage of error can be written as the relative error into 100%. That means if you express the relative or fractional error in percentage, then call it percentage error. This is the process. In this way you can calculate the percentage error of a physical quantity, mean value of a physical quantity, relative or fractional error of a physical quantities. Now we have to know the process of error calculation. Now any physical quantity and related as one, it can be related as summation of two values or any physical quantities as related to subtraction of two values. Third, any physical quantities as related as product of two quantities and division of two quantities. Now you have to know the process of error calculation in this situation. Then the fractional error, that means the relative error of x equals to relative error of A plus relative error of B. That means fractional error will be written as del of A by A plus del of B by B. That means fractional error can be written as follows, and percentage of error can be written as del of A by A plus del of B by B into 100%. In this situation, it can be written as del x by x fractional error can be written as del of A divided by A plus del of B divided by B. This is plus, not minus, because in error always be added, not subtract. Error always added, not subtract. So this minus value becomes plus. So the fractional error in this situation will be this, then the percentage of error will be del of A divided by A plus del of B divided by B into 100%, that will be del x by x into 100, and here will be 100%. In this situation, what will be happen? Then del x, the fractional error, del x by x equals to del of A by A plus del of B by B. The percentage of error will be del x by x into 100 equals to del of A by A plus del of B by B into 100%. If this product can be written as x equals to a to the power m, b to the power n, and c to the power q, then what will be the percentage of error? Percentage of error will be written as m into del A by A into 100% plus n into del B by B into 100% plus Q into del C by C into 100%. In this way, you can calculate the percentage of error of calculation of X with help of A, B and C. If in this situation, what will be happen? Then fractional error will be del of A by A plus del of B by B, and percentage of error will be del x by x into 100% will be del of A by A plus del of B by B into 100%. If x can be written as a to the power m and b to the power n, then it will be del x by x into 100% will be del of A by A, here the power value m into del of A by A into 100 plus n into del of B by B into 100%. This is the formula. By using this formula, you can calculate any error of a physical quantities. This is the situation. Another two situation. Another two situation is if the equivalent resistance can be written as parallel resistance can be written as follows. If two resistance are connected in parallel, the equivalent resistance in will be R1 R2 by R1 plus R2. Then the percentage error of the equivalent resistance will be del R1 by R1 plus del R2 by R2 plus del R1 plus del R2 divided by R1 plus R2 or into 100%, or it can be written as del of R1 by R1 plus del of R2 by R2 plus del of R1 by R1 plus R2 plus del of R2 by R1 plus R2. This is multiplied by 100. This is the rule to calculate any error of a physical quantities. Now, here you see the type 1 problem. Type 1 problem is the y is a physical quantity is related to A, B and C according to this equation. And here the y physical quantity is related to the A, B, C, D according to this equation. Then if the percentage of error A, B and C are respectively 1%, 3% and 2%, then what will be the percentage of error of y? And here, what is the percentage of error of y? Here, the percentage of error, percentage of error, percentage of error, error of y equals to percentage of error A plus 2 into percentage of error B plus 3 into percentage of error C. That means percentage 1% plus 2 into 3% plus 3 into 2%. That means 1 plus 6 plus 6 mean 13%. That means error percentage of error of y will be 13%. And here the percentage of error of y will be here 4 into percentage of error A, and here 2 into percentage of B plus here is 1/3 into percentage of error of C plus 4/3 percentage error of D, because here is 4, that means D to the power 4 by 3, and here C to the power 1 by 3. If you put the value of percentage of A, B and C and D, it will be 4 into A is 2% plus 2 into B is 3% plus 1/3 into C. Here is C is 4%, C is 4% plus the 4/3 into percentage of D, that means 5, that is 5, then it will be 8 plus 6 plus 4 by 3 plus 20 by 3. This is can calculate this 3 is 24 plus 18 plus 4 plus 20. It can be written as 22%. The error of this will be 22%. Here the third number problem is, if the error for measurement of radius is 2%, then what will be the maximum error of volume and surface area of a sphere? Here the percentage error of R equals to 2%, and volume V volume equals to 4/3 pi R cube. The percentage error of volume will be 3 into percentage error of R, that means 3 into 2 equals to 6%, and surface area S equals to 4 pi R square, that means percentage error of S will be 2 into percentage error of R, that means 2 into 2 equals to 4%. Here is type 2 problem. Type 2 is, if the current I is and V is, voltage is V is 20 plus minus 0.4 volt, then what will be the value of resistance and percentage of error of calculation of resistance? Here V equals to, here is V equals to IR, you know the it, then R equals to V by I. V by I, according by using this formula, you can calculate that R equals to, here V is 20 and I is 10 equals to 2 ohm. Now you have to calculate the mean absolute error. That means del R by R equals to del V by V plus del I by I. Then del R by R equals to, here is del V equals to 0.4, and V is 20, plus del I equals to 0.2 and I is 10, and this will be, here will be, that means 1 by 40, 4 by plus 1 by 50. Then the del R will be 1 by 40 plus 1 by 50 into R. Here the value of R is 2, that means 1 by 40 plus 1 by 50 into 2. Now you have to calculate that what is the 1 by 1 divided by 40. That means it will be 0.025 plus 0.02 into 2. That means it will be 0.045 into 2. That means it will be 0.05909. Then the value of resistance will be 2 plus minus 0.09. Here is, one by 40, here is 0.4 divided by 20, that means 200 by 4 by 200, 40, here is 50, then the relative error will be 0.09, then the value of resistance can be written as, then you have to calculate the percentage of error. Percentage of error can be written as del R by R into 100. Here is del R equals to 0.09 divided by R equals to 2 into 100. That means it will be 9/2. 9/2, that means 4.5. Then the percentage of error in calculation of resistance will be 4.5%, and the value of resistance will be 2 ± 0.09. in this way you can calculate any measurement of error. Now the second problem is, what is the second problem? Second problem is, here the two resistance are connected in parallel, then the equivalent resistance will be, if resistance are connected with parallel, then the equivalent resistance will be R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2. Here the R1 is 5 plus 0.2 and R2 is 10 plus 0.1 plus minus 0.1. Then the equals to 100% percentage of error will be del R1 by R1 plus del R2 by Chiki R2 plus del R1 plus del R2 divided by R1 plus R2, and this is multiplied by 100%. Here del R1 is 0.2 and here is 5 plus del R1 is 1.1 divided by 10 plus del R1 is 0.2 plus 0.1, and this is multiplied by 10 plus 5 plus 10. This is can be multiplied by 100. Then it will be here is 0.04 plus 0.01 plus here is 15 and 0.3, that means 0.04, and multiplied by 100, that means 0.01 plus, this will be a 0.02 and is multiplied by 100, that means 0.067 into 100, that means 7%. If two resistance are connected in parallel, then the percentage of error of equivalent resistance will be 7%. If these two resistance are connected in series, then what will happen? Here in series connection, R equivalent equals to R1 plus R2, then R equivalent divided by R equivalent into 100% will be del R1 by R1 plus del R2 by R2 into 100%. Then it will be 0.2 divided by 5 plus 0.1 divided by 10 into 100%. This will be 0.2, that means 0.04 plus 0.01 into 100, that means 0.05 into 100, that means 5%. Here you see that the type 3 problem, the energy is related to time. The energy ET is related to time according to this relation. The value of alpha is 0.2 second inverse. You have to calculate the percentage of error of E at time 5 second. To calculate the percentage of error of E, it taken log in both sides, then it will be 2 ln A minus alpha T. If we take log with base E in both sides, then it will be ln E equals to 2 ln A minus alpha T. If you take the derivative, then it will be del E by E equals to 2 del A by A. This value will be positive minus alpha del T. Then the percentage of error in calculation of E can be written as 2 into del A by A into 100%. This will be plus, because in calculation of percentage of error always be added, not subtract. That's why this value, this sign is converted to plus. That means alpha, this will be del T by T into 100 into T. Because this T and T is cancelled out, then del T into 100 will be del T into 100. Then del E by E into 100 percentage will be 2 into. Here the percentage of error TA is, here is percentage of error A is 1.25 and percentage of T is 1.5%. Then the del A by A into 100 equals to 1.25 plus the value of alpha is 0.2, and the del T by T into 100 will be 1.50, and the value of T is given by 5 seconds. Then it will be 2.5 plus, here is 0.2 into 1.5, 0.2 into 1.5, 0.2 into 1.5 into 5. Then it will be 30, that means 0.3 into 5, 2.5 plus 1.5, that means 4%. The percentage here, the energy E is related to time as ET equals to A square e to the power alpha T, and value of alpha is 0.2 second. And here is given that the percentage of error of A is 1.25 and percentage error of T is 1.50%. Then the percentage of error of E can be calculated as follows. Now here is the another problem. Here the time period then t equals to 2 pi root over l by g. That means g will be 4 pi square l divided by t square. Then the del g by g into 100% can be written as del l by l into 100, because this is a constant term, and plus 2 into del t by t into 100%. That means it will be del l by l, del l means 0.1 divided by 20 into 100, plus 2 into 1 by 90 into 100, 5, 0.5 plus 20 by 9, that means 0.5 plus 3 point, here is 20 by 9, that means 2.2, that means 2.7, here 2.7%. Then the percentage of error will be 2.7%.